Welcome to this video lesson on Introduction to Returns. After completing this, you will be able to explain the importance of returns and calculate simple returns. During March 2020, the stock market declined sharply due to the effect of COVID-19 pandemic declaration. On March 18, suppose the stock price of Google and Pinterest are as shown on the screen. In the next 2 weeks, both companies registered an increase in their stock price. If both stocks had an equal risk profile, which stock has performed better? On the surface, it looks like you have made a gain of $100 from Google, compared to $3 in Pinterest. So, Google performed better than Pinterest. But that is not true. To arrive at the right answer, you can allocate an equal amount of capital to each of the stocks, and then compare the profits. Let us allocate $1,000 to each of the stocks. With $1,000, you can buy one share of Google. Later, the share price of Google increased to $1,100. That resulted in the total profit of $100. Similarly, with $1,000, you can buy 100 shares of Pinterest. The price increased from $10 to $13, resulting in total profit of $300. Pinterest is the better choice. That is the intuitive way to look at the things. A more simplified version is to compare profit per $1 allocated. This can be obtained simply by dividing profits by the purchase price. This ratio is called the returns. As seen on screen, you would have made $0.3 on Pinterest compared to $0.1 on Google. In other words, you would have made 30% returns in Pinterest compared to 10% returns in Google. You know the starting and ending value of both the stocks, but what happened in between is still unknown. For instance, if Pinterest had fallen by 20%, then the stop loss would have hit for many traders. They would have failed to capture the 30% rise from the purchase price. Therefore, it is important to know the path.